either.
I think Biden, and I think if Biden runs in 2020, I think he'll win.
So you think he's going to win if he runs in 2020 against Trump?
I think the odds would have to be in his favor for a couple of reasons.
Biden runs 2020, he beats Trump?
I think that I'd be surprised if not. But again, I won't put money on it because I lost a lot of money on the last election, right? I put my money where my mouth was, and I lost a crap load of money because I bet on the stats.
So, how much
bet on the stats, man. Don't give odds.
How much of the conspiracy do you buy into the fact that Clinton's had a meeting with Biden to tell him not to run? Did you read up on that at all?
Did you look up? So what I do buy is that they went to Barack Obama, and they said to Obama that we're going to use some of the money that we gather to help pay off your 2012 campaign, and also that, you know, I'm obviously going to win the nomination. Don't back Biden. I think that it was really more about Obama backing Biden than it was about the Clintons.
So you
Biden
do believe that event took place?
Well, there's no question that Obama probably should have backed Biden in the primaries, and probably Hillary and Bill went to him and said, here's all the reasons why you shouldn't back Biden. And then Obama refused to support Biden in the primaries, and that was it for Biden.
How much different would have things been if Biden ran?
He would have won. I mean,
if he's president today, what would have been different than what Obama was?
A lot of things would have been different. I think that you wouldn't have the tax cuts, which I think are quite good. I think that you wouldn't have the foreign policy, which is a lot better than the Obama foreign policy with regard to Iran. You wouldn't have it with regard to the new alliance building in the Middle East between Saudi Arabia, Israel, Egypt, Jordan. You wouldn't have the movement of the embassy to Jerusalem. You wouldn't have harsher measures in Ukraine against the Russians. You wouldn't have a domestic policy that was cutting regulation. This is why I say that I didn't vote for Trump last time, but pretty good shot I'd vote for him this time, because I had three worries about President Trump going in. Right? My worries were one, that he wasn't going to govern conservative because he had no record. And not only did he have no record, he was all over the place during the campaign. So he'd say things like, Obamacare's the worst, it's just terrible. And then he would turn around, he'd say, universal health care for everyone. He'd be like, okay, well, which one of those is it? Because you got to pick. So I was worried about his policy. That worry's been largely alleviated, at least in the first year and a half, because he's governed conservative, like more conservative than anyone I can remember. He's given us Gorsuch, he's given us a bunch of appellate court justices. Like, all of this stuff is really good. My second worry is that he was gonna soul suck the Republican Party, meaning Republicans were gonna stop being conservative, and they were instead gonna look at Trump as a thought leader on issues like free trade or like Russia or on his kind of vulgar personal behavior. I don't think that's really happened so much. I think that people voted for him because they wanted the policy and because they didn't like Hillary Clinton. And I think that if somebody who were classier as a human being were to run for president and be popular enough, they'd follow that person too. So I think that worry's been at least partially alleviated. Mm-hmm. You know, it's sad to watch. I think some people make excuses for his bad behavior. I think there are a lot of people on the right who make excuses for him, which I don't agree with. I can praise his policy and still think that he's kind of a heel when it comes to his personal behavior, and not kind of, a heel when it comes to his personal behavior. And then there's, number three, which is him poisoning the well with a lot of young people. And I was really worried that he was going to become, as the face of the Republican Party, this toxic figure standing above the entire conservative movement. And anytime I try to convince somebody, people go, oh, well, look at Trump. I mean, you're backing him, and he's the worst. And I still worry about that, but I think the damage has largely been done already. So yeah, him being reelected would not exacerbate the damage. It would just be a continuation of what's already happened. So most of the damage happened when he was elected in that respect. So a lot of my worries about him being elected have either been alleviated, or they have been obviated by the fact that he's already the president. So
it sounds like you're going to be you're going to lead his political campaign 2020.
I would highly doubt that. But yeah, I'm not sure that the president wants somebody out there on the campaign trail calling him a heel personally. But
here's a question for you: is he a president without Kellyanne Conway?
Yeah.
No. If he didn't bring Kellyanne Conway on his team,
Kellyanne was not the person who moved the ball. Neither was Bannon.
Really?
Yeah,
you don't give a lot of credit to Kellyanne Conway?
It wasn't the messaging. Trump didn't change. Okay, Trump was the same Trump in the primaries.
I think she schooled a lot of these CNN and MSNBC hosts when she would sit there, and America was watching, and her interviews and persuasion.
I think Kellyanne is good at her job, but I don't think that, you know, I don't think things radically changed.
Interesting.
Kellyanne Conway's not on the campaign. I think that the presidential race is between the two candidates, and Trump won. So it's more about Trump than anybody else.
So you're saying right now, you're not willing to put money on it, but you're saying right now, 2020, Biden runs, he's probably going to be winning.
Yeah, you'd have to say that probably. Yeah. Just by the data. I mean, he's got a much higher approval rating. Trump is personally unpopular. And also Trump, he emits this feeling of chaos all the time. Like, if Trump would just go into a basement for 2 years and just let everything calm down and cut out with the Twitter and just, you know, sign a bill every so often, go to his rallies with all the people that he likes, then I think he'd be in real good shape. But here's the thing, and I've said this to top members of the administration. Between 2000 and 2004, George W. Bush had to pick up 11 million additional votes in order to win. Right? In 2000, he lost by 500,000 popular votes. In 2004, he wins by about 1.5 million. He has to pick up 10 million votes between 2000 and 2004. Do you know a person in the United States who did not vote for Trump last time who's going to vote for him next time aside from me? Right? And there's not a ton of people who are out there who have been convinced to vote Trump now. Certainly not 10 million. Certainly not 12 million.
He lost the
popular vote by 2.5 million. Right? It's the flukiest election in American history. Yes. He loses the popular vote by 2.5 million. He's going to have to pick up 12 to 13 million votes in the next election cycle in order to win. Are there 12 to 13 million voters who are going to show up to the polls and vote for Trump when they either didn't vote last time or voted for Hillary Clinton? I find that very hard to believe because, again, he is not somebody who's winning people over. Now, it's a binary race, right? So that means that I can say that in a vacuum, but it's possible. If they run somebody like Kamala Harris or Kirsten Gillibrand or somebody really off-putting, then Trump could win. But if they run Biden, Biden is a known quantity. People are relatively comfortable with him.
Very.
He's
on both sides, by the way.
There's a lot more comfort. I'm not comfortable with him. I think he's terrible. But there is a sense of, we've seen this guy before. So if he runs again, it's like, okay, back to stasis, back to normalcy. I think he'd have a heavy advantage in a run against.
But it's going.
The polls show that, by the way, that he's, I think it's like 53-38 right now.
But the polls showed Hillary was supposed to embarrass Trump, and Trump should have just left and gone to China for 6 months for vacation.
This is true.
And just stay there.
True and not true. So the national polls showed that she was going to win by anywhere from 3 to 5 points. She won by 3. So the national polls were actually right. It was the state polls that were really skewed. So when I say the national polls show, you know, Biden embarrassing Trump, again, that could change. We're 3 years out. But I do place more credence in national polls because they have a broader sample size and because the sample is spread out over a wider possible area. You don't have quite as much room for error as you do in these state polls.
It's going to be interesting. What are the chances of Elizabeth Warren?
I think that she could win primaries, but it depends on who else runs in the primaries. So she's got the Hillary Clinton problem, which is that 30% of the base of the Democratic Party in primaries is minority, is black. And that means that if Kamala Harris runs against Elizabeth Warren, a lot of Democrats vote for Kamala Harris, and a lot of black votes vote for Kamala Harris.
Her.
And that's a problem, right? It's the 2008 race all over again, basically. Yep. Then you've got Obama versus Hillary Clinton with Elizabeth Warren playing Hillary Clinton.
And we know how that ended.
Right.